My name is Taylor Schwartz. I'm from Palmdale, California. In real estate, yes, being young is definitely a disadvantage right now. As I get older, my years and my experience will grow, but right now, it's definitely hard, especially trying to do high-end real estate with high-end clientele. I moved out to Hollywood as soon as I graduated high school. I just, I want to be a star, and I feel like Hollywood is where everybody goes to be a star. I am Black, Russian, and German, so my mom is Black, and my dad is half Russian, half German. I was raised by my dad. My mom wasn't around due to her drug addiction. My dad, like, did such a great job of playing both roles, but now that I can, like, look back on my childhood and reflect, I see that growing up with just my dad and not having my mom around has affected who I am today and my relationship with women and my relationship with my mom. I feel like it's just hard for me to trust women. I don't really have a lot of girlfriends. I look for more relationships to be my support and my happiness rather than friendships. I feel like within the cast, being younger, I feel like everybody honestly likes me and they probably want to be my friend, and I don't blame them. But I also feel like they don't take me as seriously and they look at me as like less than them. The most difficult thing about being a celebrity realtor is that they have no loyalty. These celebrities, they're all about just getting what they want and whoever can get it to them first. They don't understand the work that goes into being a real estate agent and how much we put into trying to make them happy. And so, you know, you can work your ass off on a deal and they can decide to go somewhere else and they don't realize like how much time and effort you put into them. The most rewarding thing about being a realtor for celebrities is the paycheck that you get if you close a deal. I mean, these celebrities have insane budgets and a whole bunch of money, and so to be able to tap into that niche of clientele, I mean, the check.
I'm Suge Jacob Knight from Los Angeles, California. The way I found myself on 11 Listings when I met Ty, and he knew that I was going through it with school and I needed to find another career path, and real estate came up. It felt like it was more natural, it was a passion, and I just took the risk because that's the best. I don't know, it felt like it was a blessing out of nowhere, so I took the opportunity. My father is, you know, Suge Knight, and he is the founder of Death Row Records, and, you know, everybody that he started with was, you know, either now a billionaire or just a huge legend in the game, and I feel like I'm like the millennial version or just the second generation of, you know, what's next. I know I finally made it when I step out from being just Suge Knight's son to Suge Jacob Knight. What makes this real estate job worth it is the experience that you get and the connections. It's like you meet all types of people, and it's like these houses, it has a lot of history with houses, and you learn so much about people and you learn so much about yourself.
My name is Ajani Scott and I'm from Lansing, Michigan. I left Michigan when I was 22 and I wanted a big change, so I ended up in Phoenix, Arizona. Lived there for 5 years and I wanted to pursue a music career. So I said, you know what, LA's right next door, let me just hop on over there. So I moved to LA and I've been there ever since. The real estate industry definitely has its perks, but that comes with a lot of hard work and perseverance. You have to stick with it. It's very difficult to balance working two jobs because I'm paying my bills by waitressing, so that's very important. But also I want to get to the next level and succeed in my real estate career, which also requires a certain amount of dedication and time. So you're constantly battling, okay, keep the lights on, pursue my dreams and do better. So it can get very difficult as far as time management. I actually am not currently pursuing music. It's not something that I'm against doing in the future if time allows it or if the spirit moves me, but I'm not necessarily looking for any recognition from my singing because that's just a personal thing that's dear to me. The most rewarding thing about being a celebrity realtor is that you get to meet celebrities face to face. There are these personalities and these judgments that you have, but you get to see them and you get to shake their hand and touch them, and they're real, just like you. So they've made it and you get to look them in the eye, and it just affirms the fact that you can make it too. Celebrities can be very demanding, very picky, very precise about what they want, what they need. They're spending a lot of money, so it's understandable, but sometimes they can be hard to accommodate. I bring the realness. I am the girl from Michigan. I moved out here. I am representing what so many people dream of doing, want to do, are afraid to do, and there's so many layers to it. I came from Michigan. Moving across the country is one thing in itself. Staying here is another thing, but then pursuing your dreams on top of that, that's big. And I think so many people are afraid to do that. They don't think that they have that power. They don't think that they have that capability. But I'm trying to show people, yes, you can. can do it.
My name is Zach Diles, and I'm from a small town called Tulare, California, in the middle of nowhere, literally. I went to Kansas State, was drafted in the 7th round of 2007, so I played 4 years for the Houston Texans, where I was drafted to. I played 1 year in Tampa Bay, 2 years in Tennessee with the Titans, and 1 year in Cleveland. Well, I was actually doing my real estate principles at the same time I was in Cleveland. I moved to LA right after I retired in the NFL. Real estate was something I knew I wanted to do, and I knew I wanted to do it in Los Angeles. And it was to a point where I was watching my niece and nephew grow up on the internet, and I'm from California, so it just made sense because they live 30 minutes from where I'm at now. So it's a family and work all tied into that. Yeah, reality TV is a lot, so I feel like I bring the energy and the knowledge to the scenario. I've done this. I've been around this kind of, not, you know, TV is different, but, you know, I played in the NFL for 8 years, so it's all synonymous. Like, okay, I had a billionaire owner who had billionaire friends, and all my friends are millionaires. Okay, you were on TV. Have you ever ran out on a tunnel on Monday night? You know what I mean? Okay, you get 2 million people an episode. 70 million watching me on a Monday night game. That's cute. You know what I'm saying? So I get it. The most rewarding thing about being a celebrity realtor? I mean, I understand that it's not really rewarding, because you have to sit here and be like, okay, our showing's at 10:30, but this dude is gonna find a way to show up at 11:15. You know what I'm saying? Or 11:45, and I just have to deal with this shit. And I understand, you know what I mean? So it's just, I have more of a broad understanding of just scheduling and conflicts and things coming up like that. Like, there's a few people who I get starstruck by, more cases than none. Like, you're a human being, I'm a human being. Like, you trying to do business, let's do some business together. But the most rewarding part about, like, working with celebrity are the referrals, like, point blank. If you do a good job with them, if they refer you to another one of their friends who is also a celebrity, you know, it's just a trickle effect, it's a domino effect. So, you know what I mean, you service one client, you know, really well, and they like how you move, how you operate, and they understand that, okay, well, this cat knows our world. So, hey, use him, you'll be fine. So, yeah, so that's the rewarding part about being able to work with celebrity, that it can expand your portfolio.
Hey, y'all, it's your boy Caesar, Black Ink CEO. And if you don't know me, the reason why is you ain't subscribed to VH1 YouTube channel. At the end of the day, you already know that's the number one channel on YouTube. And if you don't got it, I guess you just watch the number two.